After unboxing the shutoff valve, take time to read the installation instruction manual step by step in case you're doing it for the first time. Now the valve spindle should be moved to the back seated position. Now slowly unlock the lock screw. And then remove the bonnet assembly. Removing the bonnet assembly without removing the bonnet screw will damage the bonnet threads and the sealing. Keep the bonnet assembly in the box with appropriate packing done to safeguard it from atmospheric dust and physical damage. The valve body must now be set against the vessel nozzle for the welding process. After the initial tag welding is done, the valve is checked for the proper placement with the vessel using a spirit level. Let's begin the welding process. Argon welding for root run avoids the formation of flux at the inner surface of the welded portion. Once the welding is completed, the welded area must be cleaned for to discard any metallic protrusions or debris. Ensure that the valve's body temperature is reduced to ambient temperature. Then the internal portion, such as the bonnet seating and the threads of the valve, should be cleaned with a clean cotton cloth. Fixing the bonnet portion right after the welding process without any proper internal cleaning might end up damaging components, which is not desirable. Properly packed bonnet section of the valve is now cleaned. O-ring and sealing materials are oiled with proper lubrication oil. Ensure valve spindle is in full back-seated position. After unscrewing the lock screw fully, the bonnet is now fixed to the valve. It is then tightened with the recommended torque. As the last and final step of this installation procedure, lock screw is fixed and tightened as per the recommended torque.